Pinstar, and this is Niche, a genetic survival game. So, I'm going to mix things up a little bit here on a Memorial Day weekend. Stellaris and Stardew Valley will be resuming on Tuesday, but I figured today I'd bring you something special. So this is Niche. You basically control a pack of these cute animal things. I don't know if they have an official name for the species. I guess you can make up your own. And just have them try to survive. You have to manage their reproduction, manage food, manage their safety from predators, explore your environment, worry about biomes, and also worry about genetics. So as they reproduce, they pass down their traits to their offspring, and having different traits gives them a potential advantage or disadvantage to the offspring, make them more healthy and viable. This game is currently in Kickstarter. In fact, it is in its final 24 hours, and as of the recording of this video, it is at 63,000 bucks, and their final stretch goal is 65,000 bucks. So let's see if we can't make that happen. This is a really fun game. I'm going to take you guys through it, see if I can't beat the YouTuber's challenge. So this is sort of a demo of the game. So let's dive right in. And yes, this is a version 0.2.2. So this is ultra mega giga early version of the game. This is like bordering on tech demo. So this is by no means feature complete, but the concept is there. Right, off we go. All right, so we start out with, Adam and Eve here, of these things, a single male and female of our little species here. Now, there's, this kind of plays like a board game almost, which is really, 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 really cool here, and leaves a strategic element to it. So each of your species get three actions per day, which is basically a turn. And every time they use an action for, well, almost everything, it uses up a unit of food. Now, this is a sort of a shared unit of food for the entire tribe here. Any of them can draw from this pool, but you want to make sure you don't run out. So the number one paramount thing is to, find and secure more things of food, but you also need to secure more offspring. So, with our female here, what I think she's going to do, let's display her abilities and her genes here. So, she's got a speed of 5, so that's the distance you can move in an action that's not in a, right now she's kind of penned in by these grasslands here. You can clear these out by exploring them. But if she had open terrain, she'd be able to move 5 spaces in a single turn. She can get 2 berries per action here, and there's a berry bush right next to us, so that handy that. So we're gonna berry bush, get 2 berries there. Luckily, it does not take a berry of energy to harvest that. So, more berries. And now, as you can see, we are picking the bush clean here. It does regrow, but it's not an infinite source of food. It regrows quite slowly. Now, let's make some babies, shall we? So we've got the male here. Now, one of the actions you can do is if you click on another member, an adult member of the thing, you can use the heart there and, she's got a little preggy belly. In order for her to give birth, or lay an egg, because it's an egg icon, I'm not too sure, she needs to end her turn in a nest. She's ending her turn in a nest. So next turn, we'll have a baby. Now we've got 2 more actions with this guy. Now we don't have to do anything with him. One of the nice things is you can conserve your energy in order to maximize your growth here. That being said, we do want to explore because that's how you find alternate sources of food. Now I see another berry bush way over here. It might be worth our while to tunnel our way over there. Because we might find something good on the way over, too. So we're going to use an action to clear a space, and we'll use an action to move there. Alright, and that is all of their actions, which is 23 food. Let's end the day. And we've got ourselves a little baby. New Ventro. Alright, now let's look at his stats. So he's got a 5 movement, that's that little paw icon. He can get 2 berries per turn once he's old enough. He's not old enough to start harvesting berries. Does 1 damage when he attacks, that's the same as his mom, and has the smell ability. Now, basically a little clone of the mom. Now, one of the things you can do to sort of get the genetic tree a little bit more varied here is up here. You can actually start selecting new traits and add them in as potential mutations. Now, there's going to be a lot of genetic traits when you get to the final version of this game. But we'll use what we have to play with here. Each of them has different statistics. Now, the big body, the big body ones like it cooler. And I'm thinking that this area up here is cooler, but since we're going to be tunneling our way up there anyway, let's put in the chance to mutate into a bigger body, because having that +2 strength will be useful. All right, so let's move her off there. Let's get some couple more berries. Now her smell ability basically lets you preview what's in these. See, sniff, 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 sniff. Nothing interesting in these right now. So. Yeah, but what we can do is we can get our preggers once again. Now he's got all 3 of his actions, so we can use him to tunnel. Now he does not have the smell ability, so I can't do the little preview. There might be interesting stuff around here, but he can't smell it. Now his advantage is, well, he moves a lot slower. He's much slower about that, but he's got a 2 attack. He's also got the poison fangs attack. Which means if he damages something and that something survives, it's going to take more damage on subsequent turns. And it also boosts his attack. So he's got a little more bite to him. He's a little bit more aggressive in that. So, well, not so much aggressive, but, you know, because you can use it for defensive purposes. All right, so we're continuing to tunnel our way there. She's got a baby in the tummy. You can't have the baby until you move the current baby off the nest. And you have to wait until they grow 1 for the babies to walk out of the nest. Alright, so now this baby has become a child, and they get 1 action point. And not to mention, they still can't take major actions like harvesting berries or exploring. They're just sitting there and growing. So we're going to move it off the nest. We're going to take mom here, put her on the nest, collect some berries while she's sitting there, have a little room service there, and then we'll just let her last action lapse. No, because again, you can conserve food. Now, there is one reason why you might want to keep active. It's this age count here. Every day, they get closer to death. They just grow old and die. And everyone is growing older and dying. So you could technically just pass the turn, like 10 turns in a row, and not take any actions. And technically, yeah, you wouldn't run out of food, but everyone's going to start getting older and dying of old age, and that's no good. Alright, so. Yeah, why don't you go here and go here? And let's end the day. She'll plop out another baby here. What do you got here? 3 movements, so she's got a little less movement there. 1 food, 1 food. So this baby is categorically better suited to survive than this one. So when this one gets older, we're gonna want to breed this one over its younger sibling here. All right, let's do some exploring with her, shall we? Sniff, 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 sniff. Okay. Move you up another one. Sniff, sniff. It smells like food. See? Ha ha! Another berry bush. Score. Speaking of, let's repregify her. I'll have her harvest the berries next turn, and then you keep going there, because we know that berry bush is there. And this little guy, we're just gonna let sit. All right, now now its little sibling is done. Eh, you move up here. Alright, one berry. There are two berries, four berries. Yeah, we were needing that. And we have, now again, she has five movements, so she can move all the way back to the nest in one fell swoop. Boop. You, my friend, finally can burrow your way out of there. Now, he's not so good at gathering, so we actually might want to send one of the kids up here. Like you! You might actually be a really good candidate to go up there just so you can just grab those berry bushes. He's not old enough yet to harvest it, but he'll eventually get there. So why don't you... Hang on. Why don't you run all the way up there? Yep, now you're a teen. You can take a couple of actions. And might as well use him to explore, too, since he's got the smell ability. Let's move you here. Sniff, sniff, sniff. Okay. Yeah, let's move you over here. It's good to have a fast speed. Yeah, we're running a little bit low here. So why don't you harvest two berries? Come on up here. Collect two more berries there. You come down here, fill her up again. Because the goal of our challenge here is to expand our group to 10 members. So we want to keep breeding as much as possible. And then him, I'm just going to let him sit. Because I don't want to burn up too much energy. Because we're stable at the moment, but we need to hook up more food sources. We need to discover them, and we need to do that as efficiently as possible. So next day. All right, you also got the shorter end of the genetic stick here, so we'll just move you out of here. Ooh, a bunny. We can om-nom them, but they move every time we do, so chasing them is actually kind of futile. Kind of have to wait, either herd them towards another member, or just wait for them to wander into your path and then nom them. Yeah, so that rabbit just ran into there. Yeah, so just use your whole turn to gobble down those berries. Miss Preggy. I should have saved one of their actions. If the rabbit runs back into their field of view, I want them to be able to nom it. And two berries there. That picks all those berry bushes nice and clean. I'm going to leave the male sitting right where he is. Let's end turn. Yeah, rabbit's still. Oh no! There's a couple of guys here. Smells like prey. And moved. And we'll have the male just gnaw one of the berries. I like how their heads follow my mouse cursor when it's their turn. See, he's used up all of his action points, so he's not following my head, your mouse cursor. But the ones that haven't taken their turns yet or still have action points. All right, here's what we're gonna do for her. Do I want to spit out another baby? Yeah, why not? Move her up here. Fill her up. You are a teen, so you can give us some free sniffs. Nothing interesting there. I don't want to move you to... I don't want to burn the... You are a child. So when you grow up to a teen, you can give us some free sniffs here. All right, let's go ahead and day. This thing right here is kind of staying kind of stubborn. Find out what that is. There's that bunny. It ran into the water. you little kid. Yeah, why don't you move up here? You run down here, collect those two berries. You can collect one berry. And that's about it. Smells like one of us, perfect. So this, you might be saying, Pinstar, how do you get more genetic diversity? Because there is inbreeding. Actually, this guy is already inbred. Having the same letter twice causes an immunity drop. I guess it doesn't seem to. That's okay. Now, what do we got here? 4 movement and a 2 attack. Very nice. Ooh! And you are female. So, yeah, why don't we load you up? Now, she can't give birth unless she's at a nest, and we haven't found any other nests yet. So, she's going to need to make her way over to a nest, but having that extra genetic diversity is a good thing. Hey, I've unlocked a new gene, eh? Nah, I want the bigger body size. Collect us a berry. Oh yeah, we're gonna have to be a little conservative here. So we do not want to run out of food. You kid, run out of the nest here. You, dang it, we don't quite make it into the nest. We're gonna have to burn 2 food to, actually get to the nest to give birth. Yeah, you get us some berries there. We do need to send out some explorers to go sniffing around. Actually, why don't you become the resident breeder female, and you... Is that... Yeah, that guy's a male, so he can knock her up next. With a minimal of effort. Yeah, because you really want to get free sniff tests. And yeah, you just keep staying there and munching those berries nice and slow. Oh boy. That sounds like a predator. Oh, and it's raining. Rain means that the berry bushes instantly fill themselves. I am willing to risk this person here to go get ourselves ultra mega harvests of berries here. Ooh, you look like you have a large body size. Yes, you do, body big. That must have been one painful birth. Alright, you aren't good at... Who the heck is good at harvesting berries? Because we don't want these berry bushes to go to waste here. The baby is good at harvesting berries. The baby's actually probably one of the better genetic ones, because you've got 4 movement, 2 attack, and 2 berry harvests. So this is good genetic stock. We just have to wait for it to get a little older before it can actually start taking useful actions. Well, we might as well do the inefficient one, because again, it doesn't take berries to gain berries. It just uses up their actions less efficiently. So here's what we're going to do. Why don't you go here? You knock her up. Guys, all nosh those. And you keep sniff testing, because you gotta find us some. You gotta find us some food. Okay. you got those berries. I'll keep you parked here for now. If the predator shows its head, I might run away. But I don't want to use the energy to. Yeah, you just keep harvesting them berries. You need to... You are pretty fast. So why don't you... Actually, we might need you on defense in the future. So why don't you move up here? You get yourself back on the nest. Eat some berries. You get some berries. And how are we over... How's our explorer? Smells like food. Oh, sweet nectar. Her own personal berry bush. Now she can just nosh on that all day long and get us a steady stream of food there. Boom! Huzzah! We took me 14 days to complete the challenge. Now, let's take this to its logical conclusion. Let's see how far we can take this. Now, there's a small chance, since this is ultra-early alpha, that it will eventually glitch out. But, you know what? Let's try it. Wow! Three attack! A three attack with one movement. I'm not sure how I feel about that. Three attack is awesome, but one movement? Like, it's ultra ferocious, but it's not going to be able to catch Jack. Alright, well, you... go pregify yourself. Grab a berry. We're going to start moving the male over there. I wish he was a little faster. You get that one berry. I'll wait for you to grow up. Nothing new. Then we've got our explorer over here, and she's just going to om-nom these berry bushes. Oh yeah, we got another mutant gene that we can unlock here. Pawberry? Is normal? I wonder what snipe radius does. We'll find out. Ah, there's our beastie. Alright, old man. Now it's time for your poison fangs to come into play. Why don't we come say hi to this carnivore? 15 hit points, huh? But we get 10 food out of him if we kill him. And I'm willing to make this guy a sacrificial lamb. He's gonna die soon anyway. So, attack! Attack! And I'm sure somewhere on there is the poison fangs doing their thing. I wonder what's over there. But I don't want to abandon my berry bush. You're still a child. Yeah, actually, why don't you come and explore? Oh yeah, Mr. One Movement. Go nom yourself a berry. None of these guys are good berry harvesters. You're a good berry harvester, though. Yeah, you picked that one clean, but I'm just gonna keep her parked there. I mean, I guess we could go exploring and bounce between two of them, but there's no guarantees. Yeah, little scaredy cat buggered off there. Send our teen up there to double team him. Three hit points. That's all he's got left. And I don't know how much damage the poison does. Paw Claw. Ooh, now that's a good one. Why don't I put the Paw Claw up there? Oh, and it's raining, so collect extra berries, please. Berries. And, well, hey, she doesn't have to move. You get yourself all the berries you could ever want. I do need to find another nest. I wish I could have more than one baby at a time. And there we go. Wait, why is he... Hang a minute. There you are, you little freak. Gotcha! So he took a point of damage, and I finished him off. Yeah, that's worth 10. So, you know what? Screw you, Predator. We ain't afraid of you. Come on, old man. You got one more kill in ya. Get that, sink that poison fangs in there. Actually, why don't we take the weak one and have him join the fun. And get some free sniffs out of the deal. Tear them apart! Pack tactics! Get them berries. What do you got? What? Sickness! Low immunity can lead to sickness. You're sick. Well, you're not inbred, so you just happen to be sick. Alright, well, we got a sickly one here. Should I get my my lumbering ogre of a child wandering up there? Probably not. If a carnivore comes around here, we'll and once it grows up, we'll be able to use it to defend. Aha! He takes a strike. Ooh, they are closing in. That bitch is another one. So, what happens, the net effect is, see how his lifespan got shorter? Those red dots on the end there? That's what happens when you take damage. You live less long. And they can effectively kill you. Alright, you are about to die, so why don't you use the last of yours to maul this predator here. And why don't you... Yep. It is a carnivore. Well, actually, you know what? Why don't we lure... Oh, hey, Mama died in the nest, giving birth. Ooh! That's not too bad there. But now we need a new breeding female. Any takers? You're female, but you're also sick. You're female, but you're still a child. And I don't really want to get into inbreeding, if at all possible. Why don't you run away? There. I don't remember if he was actually their sister or not. Sister, brother. Oh. Sure, why not? Ah, that is a gigantic belly there. Hopefully we can find a nest. So I am actually going to have this one go exploring. Because he's got the nose for it. Unfortunately, you old man, you're gonna perish. Look at you! The ogre! The ogre has grown. couple turns. Dang it! Yeah, I think he's just dead. Alright. Well, first off, why don't you meander over here and do some berry harvesting? A little bit of exploring, and why don't we move the ogre up to the predator here? Ouch! Movement. That's all I can do. is fight off predators. I don't even really want to breed it because it's not diverse enough. You're about to die of the sickness here. You too. Well, you're pregnant. Well, maybe we can have you limp into the nest here. Oh yeah, you're good. So yeah, you limp into the nest. Yeah, child cannot harvest the berries, unfortunately. You're a teen, though. Female, male, that's about to die. What's your speed? 2? Ah, it's a rock. Now, not much left you can do. You're gonna be a. This guy right here is gonna be our all-star. Yeah, the tribe is getting down there in size. Ooh, what do you have? 2-2 and the smell ability. Eh! No, but this guy right here, you're gonna be on permanent baby-making duty. And we need some good females here, like you. 2 with the berry. Yeah, these two right here, awesome breeding pair once they've aged up enough. I'm going to keep you here so you can gnaw them on the berry bushes here. You can keep exploring. And we can't forget our explorer over here. Keep our food supply up nice and high. Oop, and a predator. Alright, well, they're over there. I'm not gonna bother. I mean, you're a male. We could, you're female, so. Well, we wait for our all-star male to get up in there. Wait, no. You're both the females. He's the male. Dang it. Kid, well, you know, you're gonna be on. No, you can't be on berry bush duty. You're gonna be on carnivore duty eventually once you grow up. And the ogre's gonna stay right there. You burn too much food. You're still a child. Why don't you pop over here so you can harvest those berries? So many berry bushes going untapped. We need more berry harvesting. Oh, come on, you're sick? No! Immunity 35, yeah. We don't have enough genetic diversity, unfortunately. Well, two berries. Can't meet with a teen, unfortunately. Don't take that quote out of context, please. It sent the ogre after the carnivore, but she's just so slow. And this little guy is also sick. Yeah. Yeah, we're suffering from inbreeding here. That's our problem. think with the full game, the group, there we go. All right, mister, it's time for you to breed. You're also a male. That doesn't help. Here, how about this? You clear that patch of ground. You come down here, knock her up, get us some berries. You come down here to go pop a squat. You come up here, get yourself a Pregzors. Heck, what the heck? We'll have the ogre come down here. Oh wait, no, the ogre. What happened to the ogre? Huh. Oh no, the ogre is male. Never mind. Alright, it is raining, so... unfortunately, we can't move the baby off, so there is a limit to the production of youngsters. Community 85! Ooh, a good healthy baby! Oh, thank goodness. So we might not be doomed after all. Alright, you go nosh some berries. I mean, all said and done, our food supply is healthy. Yeah, the ogre's gonna die soon. I'm not gonna bother moving them. We do need to discover a freaking, another freaking nest. Mr. Teen! Well, you have the smell ability, Mr. Teen. Why don't you be our explorer? Ugh, even more sickness. Maybe keeping them, let's see, three movement, three attack, and can harvest berries. That's a great baby right there. I will take that. All right, you are Tepregzors, so let's get you in there. And our star here. We'll harvest us some more berries. But don't tell me he's about to... Alright, good. He better not be about to die. You're the ogre. You're gonna die soon. Clear a little way out here. You're gonna die soon. Hopefully you don't die next turn. Actually, you might die next turn. Oh, hi there! Hey, the ogre! No! No! Come on! The one time the ogre would be useful is when the predator shows up and he's like, nope, I'm gonna die right now. Great. I don't want our star male here taking damage. He's already taken enough damage from this freaking sickness. And you knock yourself back up. And, another source of food. A gopher hole. Not bad. And you're still a baby. All right, Pred, what are you gonna do? Ow, no, don't take out my star mail. Aw, man. Well, I'm gonna take you down swinging. Try and squeeze out this kid, this last kid here. And you, Om Nom that mole. Maybe he'll get distracted. And there goes our star mail. Ooh, but this one is now viable. 3 and 3 with the... I think it's some clawing time. Wait, are you... Yeah, you're male, but again, inbreeding. And, well, teen. You're an adult. What are you at? 9 of 15? Load her up. Protect her. You get us some of those. And yeah, you're just gonna camp over here and keep eating berries till you die. And you might be drowning. Hey, it's another star male. I mean, granted, still has to age up a little bit. All right, you, just maul this freaking. 3 and 5, I think it's worth it to take him out. Just that way he doesn't get an attack on somebody. Yeah, and you sit here and farm some berries for us. Wish I knew what was in there, but I can't have the, Oops! Alright, what did we get here? Tiger Light Stripes. Okay, eventually if you play this game long enough, it hangs up on nighttime. Again, super early alpha. This is a fun game, but also a good stopping point here. And not an easy one to do in the long term. I mean, yeah, I blitzed for the 10 population, but I'm back down to 6 to 10 now, and I'm just treading water here. So this is a tricky game, and it looks like it'll get a little bit more complex and more advanced once they fully develop it. So I am extremely, extremely excited for it. So as a reminder, it is in Kickstarter. This is the last day for Kickstarter. 24 hours, can we get that final stretch goal? Maybe, maybe not, we'll find out. That depends on you guys. You can find a link to the Kickstarter campaign down in the comments. Not in the comments. The description. Yes, I know what I'm doing. So, if you like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Leave me a comment, good, bad, or indifferent. Your feedback is always welcome. So until next time, this has been Pinstar, signing out. See ya.